Prophetess Gabile, 7750 Media. As mentioned in the last video, it was in 1963 that Hilda Cooper published her work titled The Swazi, a South African Kingdom. It was also in 1963 that both the current King of Lesotho and Elizabeth Whitney Houston were born. I hear Whitney Houston's rendition of the hymn, Guide Me, O Thou Great Jehovah, and I have been guided indeed. I have made it patently clear that as I continue my work in my house, I have been the subject, and I have been subject to the most barbaric and extreme forms of ritual narcissistic abuse, demonic and occultically driven gaslighting, emotional, psychological, mental and spiritual abuse, anger outbursts accompanied by temper tantrums, intimidations and threats on my life, often being told that third parties, like the King of Lesotho or the doctors of the family, of the law, or other people with political and social clout are going to sue me or kill me or carry out actions that will render me jailed or dead or grievously harmed or definitely permanently silenced in some way. I've also made it clear that whereas a simple divorce would have sufficed in a private matter of a marriage in the household, my marriage became not just a public fiasco, but the most dangerous threat on my life. As we speak, I am gagged from saying certain things because of a protection order granted to protect the perpetrator of years and years of narcissistic abuse against me and my children. This abuse did not just take a toll on my mental and physical health, but also on the mental and physical well-being of my children. When I posted the video about Thabo Mbeki and his fall, when I posted the video about Thabo Mbeki and his fallout with the award-winning journalist Charlene Smith, the most important detail of that story was not that she was asked by Mark Gevisser if she had sexual relations with Thabo Mbeki, but that Mark Gevisser was in a difficult position because if he told the real story about the man, he would have to leave South Africa and make sure he was never found again. And this is not of my own making. This is directly from the article that Charlene Smith wrote about her fallout with Thabo Mbeki. The point I have been making is that democracy is the lie of the Antichrist to make people feel and believe that they have all these freedoms of the press, freedoms of expression, LGBTQ, and God knows what else has been added to this list, Rainbow Pride, BSX worker of all types, anything and everything that undermines good morals and stable families, including drug parties. Yet behind the scenes, politicians and businessmen and clergy, so-called priests and pastors of churches, have built all kinds of empires and kingdoms where the main trade that is being conducted is sex. But that's not all. Women and children are being abused through the establishments and political structures and institutions and are protected through their networks of powerful people. And this is why, even as I sit here, I am under threat of being effed up by ministerial concubines and mistresses in charge of big business and government portfolios because they have sponsored livelihoods, careers, reputations, and business deals for leading personalities of Alpha Phi Alpha Brotherhood, their friends and inner circles of the royal dynasty. And if what I am saying is not true, what about Prince Andrew? What about Jeffrey Epstein? What about P. Diddy? What about Harvey Weinstein? What about R. Kelly? The list goes on and on. To date, I have not heard if these all-powerful women of sex business deals have effed up the friends of the inner circle that disseminated the pages of the Robert F. Kennedy type sex ledgers with accounting scores of performances and such services rendered. It is the democracy of the United States that has created, that has not just created sex predators and pedophiles that we see falling off their thrones in recent times, but it has empowered them and enabled them through the very institutions that should have been protecting the ones that have been exploited by the system of sex exploitation. The Americans, the British, and the West has created environments that allow criminals and sex predators to thrive, getting away with the most evil and heinous of sexual abuse and violence. And the very elected public officers not just protect these vile individuals who conduct these businesses for trafficking sex slaves and presidential models, but some of them even partake in the very activities. The only reference that I find in my extensive digital library that makes any mention of sex trafficking is in The Voice. At the end of Amos chapter 2, before the beginning of Amos chapter 3, The Voice Bible records that we are appalled to hear of horrible atrocities and crimes against humanity. Today, we work to put an end to ethnic cleansing and sex trafficking. But these crimes are nothing new. Consider the world Amos occupies. It is a world where the Philistines, the most technologically advanced people in their region, sell people into slavery, where the Edomites attack their neighbors in hand-to-hand combat and violently end their lives, where Ammonites rip open pregnant women in order to annex a few more acres of land, and where Israelites, God's own covenant people, sell the needy while both father and son have sexual relationships with the same woman. If we are appalled to hear these stories, imagine how much more God the Father of all is angry with those that act in these ways. A couple of videos ago, I spoke about the lady, a rehabilitated sex slave by the name of Bryce Taylor, who wrote a book titled Thanks for the Memories. In it, she speaks of being forced to have sex with both Prince Philip and Prince Charles. And that book is available on Amazon for anyone who wants to look up the details for themselves. And even on the internet, if you search, you will find that story. Since God's prophet Amos knows his mind, he will not sit idly by and let the poor and right living suffer. The prophet Amos takes me directly to the gate and the house of the late patriarch of the Kumalo clan of the kingdom of Eswatini, and that is Zonke Amos Kumalo. It's not the first time I mention his name. God is going somewhere, but I am going to leave it here for now. Thank you for listening.